أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستنصره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صفيه وخليله بعثه الله هاديا ومبشرا ونذيرا وداعيا من الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا فبلغ رسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين أما بعد أيها الإخوة الكرام أيها الأخوات الفاضلات الدين الإسلامي دين قائم على مبدأ الوسطية لأن الله عز وجل وصف هذه الأمة فقال عنها وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا فهذه الوسطية في الإسلام تدل على الاعتدال والتوازن في كل شؤون الحياة ومن أهم الوسطيات التي تراها في الإسلام أو من أهم التوازن الذي تراه في الإسلام هو التوازن في موضوع الحياة في موضوع الدنيا وموضوع الدين تطرق إلى هذا الموضوع أخونا الدكتور بلال فيليبس ولكن حقيقة أن نعطي حقه أيضا يتابع الكلام أمر مهم فالإسلام جاء ليقول أن هذه الدنيا هي مزرعة للآخرة فيجب الاهتمام بها لأنها وسيلة وقال عن الآخرة أنها الغاية الهدف فلا تستطيع أن تصل إلى الهدف بدون وسيلة ولكن الوسيلة لابد أن تكون وسيلة مشروعة فأن تجعل هذه الدنيا مطية للآخرة من خلال ما أوصاك الله عز وجل به في هذه الدنيا فهناك نزعتين عند الناس نزعة طلقت الدنيا وآثرت الآخرة فهذه النزعة التي يعني طلقت الدنيا زهدوا فيها واحتقروها وقالوا عن هذه الدنيا أنها محتقرة أنها ملعونة أنها كذا أنها كذا وتعلقوا في الآخرة ونسوا نصيبهم من الدنيا مثل الثلاثة نفر اللي جاءوا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وكأنهم تقالوا عبادة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقالوا أنت نبي فأما أنا أول واحد قال فأما أنا فإني أنام فإني أقوم ولا أقوم والثاني قال أنا أصوم الدهر دائما أصوم والثالث قال أنا لا أتزوج النساء هذه رهبانية هذا انقطاع عن الدنيا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رد ذلك هذا الانقطاع عن الدنيا رده فقال أما أنا نبي فأما أنا فإني أتزوج النساء وإني أصلي وإني أصوم وأفطر، فمن رغب عن سنتي فليس مني. هذا انقطاع الدنيا. وعلى النقيض الآخر هناك ناس عبدوا الدنيا فقالوا نحن نعيش، هذه هنا البداية وهنا النهاية. عبد الدنيا، هنا البداية وهنا النهاية، ما إن هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا وما يهلكنا إلى الدهر، وإن هي إلا حياتنا وما نحن بمبعوثين، ما في بعث. فطالما أنهم ليس هناك بعث فاستكبروا وعلوا وطغوا، لأنهم يريدون أن يحصلوا من الدنيا ما يستطيعون الحصول عليه. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال عن هذا الصنف: تعس عبد الدرهم، تعس عبد الدينار، تعس وانتكس، وإذا شيك فلم تغش. فالإسلام دين جاء يوازن بين الدنيا وبين الدين. قال: خذ من دنياك ما يفيد آخرتك، خذ من دنياك ما يفيد آخرتك، واعمل لآخرتك بأن تجعل هذه الدنيا هي مزرعة، فتصلي هنا وتزكي هنا وتتصدق هنا وتعبد الله هنا وتقرأ القرآن هنا من أجل هناك، من أجل هناك. فمن آثر أحدهم مع الآخر يعني طلق الدنيا أخطأ، إلا أنا طلقت الدنيا أنا لا أخطأ، ومن طلق الآخرة أخطأ، لأن هذا الإنسان ترك الآخرة عبد الدنيا، وذلك عبد الدنيا وطلق الآخرة، وكلاهما على خطر عظيم. أما الإسلام فقال: وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا، هذه الوسطية، هذا هو التوازن الحق، التوازن. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this ummah is the ummah of the middle path. And when we say the middle path, it is the ummah of balance. And the most important balance you can see, as Dr. Bilal Philips mentioned in his khutbah, the most important balance you can see is between deen and dunya. And among this issue, between deen and dunya, would you please, brother, come forward, please? Could you please come forward? Yeah, we still have a place. Jazakumullah. So for deen and dunya, this is a critical issue that's been there for a long, long time. From the time of Adam till now, you can see people differ in this issue. You can see people having some messy understanding. Even if we go to the Judaism, in the Judaism, when you see the text in the Old Testament, that it will tell you whatever you do anything, the reward will be here in this dunya. You're doing this, the reward will be in the dunya. In the Bible, on the other hand, in the Bible, that the Bible neglects the dunya and wants the people to connect with Akhirah only. Therefore, you can see the people who are monks or priests, they have the issue of rahbaniyya. Rahbaniyya mean is to neglect this dunya, is to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to get married. If you have money, give it away. Sit in the church, don't do anything except serving Allah. In the Judaism, you can see everything's materialistic and everything connected to this dunya. On the Christianity, you can see everything's connected to the Akhirah. They want people. Some people in the Dark Ages, some priests used not to take shower for years, not taking shower. Because they see this is, if you take shower, this is mean you have some luxury in the life. So you're doing too much. So we are connected to God. They don't have any things, any money. They eat little bit. And they don't, they really give, neglect the need of the body, neglect this dunya, and they connect with Akhirah. So in Islam the balance religion. But does that mean that Muslims did not have this problem? Yeah. The Muslims also have this disease. Some people in the time of the Prophet ﷺ came to the Prophet ﷺ and they said, "You are a prophet. We are not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all your sins. But we can't be in your level." The first one said, three of them, first one said, "I'm not going to marry a woman. Because I want to really focus on Akhirah. Meaning women, mean kids, mean children, mean family, mean paying attention to them. Someone gets sick, someone this, being busy. So I'm going to forget about Akhirah, so I don't want to get married. Period. The second person said to the Prophet, he said, I am not going to sleep at night. I'm going to keep worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at night. Every night I'm going to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if I don't do that, then I might be a loser. The third person said, I'm going to keep fast day after day that to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is neglecting the body, neglecting the needs. It is not from the Islam. He told them, I am a prophet, but I do marry women, because this is ibadah. I do marry women, I do pray at night and I do sleep, and I do fast and I do break my fast. The one who is going against my sunnah, he is not from a ummah. He's not from my ummah. Neglecting the needs of the body, it will drive you away from ummah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Your body has needs. And this need has to be met. And you need to work for that. Because this is ibadah in itself. On the other hand, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw people neglecting the akhirah and attached to the dunya, he told them, this is the story, and this is the second story. When he saw people connected to the dunya, and they only cared about this dunya, he told them, this group of people, he told them, Ta'isa abdul dirham, Ta'isa abdul dinar, Ta'isa wal takas wa iza shika falan taqash. The one who worshipped dunya, the one who is worshipping dirham, dirham is a currency in that time. Dollar in this time, dollar or gold or silver or even dress. Some people when they dress, their dress costs thousands of dollars. They only dress from Paris, from England. They ask for their clothes, even their cars, thousands, thousands. They're equipped to be like this. They are into it. Some women and men. You can see that her dress $10,000 or $20,000. They're attached to this dunya, attached to the worldly life, attached to the materialistic issues. So the Prophet ﷺ said about those who are really connected to the dunya, don't be a worshipper. Don't be a worshipper of a dunya. Don't be a worshipper of dinar. Don't be a worshipper of a dollar. So be a worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the balance. The balance is we use this dunya as a farm for akhirah. Whatever you plant here, you're going to get there. But the issue is today we have some Sufis in Islam. Some Sufis, they say, I'm going to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night. I'm going to go out da'wah, giving da'wah. And I'm going to go here, go out for 1 year, go out for 2 years, neglecting the need of his family, neglecting his needs. This is even Sufism, this is wrong Sufism. We know that there is good Sufism and there is bad Sufism. The good Sufism is when you make this tawfiq, this balance. The bad one, when you neglect the dunya and you said, I'm gonna connect with Allah only. And you know, some people in the time of Umar al Khattab, one person in the time of Umar al Khattab, he saw him praying Dhuhr. And he came for Asr, he saw him in the Asr time, staying there from Dhuhr to Asr. He came to him and said, man, who are you? He said, he told him his name. He said, is there anybody providing to you? From where you get your money to live? I saw you from Dhuhr to Asr. So is it gonna happen again and again? He said, I have a brother who work and provide for me. Oh, get out. He told him, get out. Because the sky will not rain gold. إن السماء لا تمطر ذهبا. السماء لا تمطر ذهبا. To rely on other, this is wrong. I'm gonna rely on my wife. I'm gonna rely on my brother. I'm gonna rely on this person. Go and work. You have to go and work. Allah told them, go and work. Because the sky will not bring money. The sky will not bring gold. You have to work for this dunya to provide for yourself, to rely on yourself. If people came to Ahmad bin Hanbal, in the time of Ahmad bin Hanbal, they told him, you know, we are the people who rely on Allah. Al-Mutawakkilun. And Imam Ahmad told them, what do you do? Said, we only sit. We don't do anything. We do dhikr. We do da'wah. We read Quran. We do all this stuff. And he said, this is the only things you do? He said, yes. Like, from where you get food? From where? They said, people will bring us. People bring us food. People bring us water. People. He said, okay, what's your proof? Why are you sitting and you're letting someone else bring you the food? Why? They said, we have a proof from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What the proof? He said, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَتَّكِلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِكُمْ لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزِقُ الطَّيْرُ تَغْدُو خِمَاصًا وَتَعُودُ بِطَانًا. If you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the birds, rely on Allah, you can see them in the morning going up with the empty stomach, coming back in the end of the day with full stomach because they rely on Allah. This is what's happening in Ahmad. Did you hear about this hadith? He said, I heard about this hadith. And I memorized a thousand by thousand hadith, a million hadith. Imam Ahmad is professional in hadith. He said, but this is not what he meant. He said, وَمَا أَعْظَمْ مِنْ أَنَّهَا تَعْدُوا وَالْدَبُوْهَا. If the bird, are the birds staying on the branches or in the nest, or they want to bring the seeds, they want in the morning to bring the, they fly. To bring the, they did an activity to get the food. They did not say and say, oh, I'm relying on Allah. So this is what is the balance in the deen. Second, which is that will lead to a critical issue that people on our welfare, on a family benefit, I'm getting money from here, I'm divorcing my wife to get money from the government. They want to sit down, they're not getting this money in halal way. They're not getting this money in halal way, and they're not doing anything toward akhirah as well. So getting money from welfare, and I said, I can't do anything. Why, yeah, you can't do anything? I see people who stand on the traffic, and some of them, the SF Muslim, they cover their hair, said, I need the help, I'm homeless. Why you need help? Why are you homeless? MashaAllah, you have a buddy. Abdurrahman bin Auf, when they migrated from Medina, from Mecca to Medina, Abdurrahman bin Auf, someone want to give him some money. He said, no, guide me to the souk. Tell me where is the market. Abdurrahman bin Auf is the richest man. He went to the souk and he started making money. He's working to stay, relying on others, relying on the government, relying even if, and I like some of the brothers from Syrian refugees. MashaAllah, they came from Syria, but yet, MashaAllah, they're not getting any help now because they're working in construction. They're working in construction. They went, they stand on their feet. They don't want to get money from anywhere because they can do it. We can do it. We should not rely on others. We should do our work. And when we do it perfectly. We don't do it and we cheat people with it. Not because you have a mechanic shop, you start stealing the money of people and cheating the people. This is wrong. You be honest, you be, and to the point. Because this is, again, you're getting your money from haram way. So when you have a shop, when you have a business, you do it right. And you do it without playing with the prices, without playing with the customers. You need to do your job perfectly. Because this is the balance in the dunya. We do it here, mazra'a. We plant here to get there. On the other hand, we can see people who divorce the masjid, divorce the Quran, divorce the sunnah, divorce, it's only they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Fridays. We don't want that. What's the connection with Allah? As we said, al-akhiratu hiya al-ghaya. Allah is our goal. Akhirah is our goal. We're seeking akhirah. We don't seek akhirah because of this dunya. We sit here in this dunya and we work for it day and night, and we forget about that we're gonna meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's gonna ask us what you have done in this dunya. So brothers and sisters, the balance here is so, so important. The person who has a garden in Surah Al-Kahf, the one who has a garden, he said, دَخَلَ جَنَّتَهُ وَهُوَ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ. Because this person who has a garden attached to the dunya, he only cared about his garden. He entered his garden and he was unjust to himself. قَالَ مَا أَظُنُّ أَن تَبِيدَ هَذِهِ أَبَدًا. This is the house I built. It's not gonna go anywhere. This is the garden I have to care of. It's not gonna tabid. It's not gonna be finished. It's not gonna be expired. وَمَا أَظُنُّ سَاعَةَ قَائِمًا. And I don't believe in sa'ah. I don't believe in the hour. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought me back, then into akhirah, I'm gonna get more, better than that. And this is rejection. فِرْعَوْن. He said to the people, أَلَمْ تَرَى أَنَّ لِيَ مُلْكَ مِصْرِ وَهَذِهِ الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي. I have the ruling of Egypt and see the rivers going beneath me. Fir'aun is the one who's attached to the dunya. The one who's in Surah Al-Kahf, attached to his garden. Attached to his garden. Forget about the sa'ah. Forget about the hour. Forget about his death. Forget the Fir'aun will be. We think in the ocean. They forgot about that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring his punishment. He brought his punishment to the garden and see what garden happened to in Surah Al-Kahf. فَأَصْبَحَتْ صَعِيدًا زَلَقًا. That's وَأَصْبَحَ مَاؤُهَا غَوْرًا فَلَا تَسْتَطِيعُ لَهُ طَلَبًا. So that you cannot even put your feet on it. The soil of it is not gonna have plants anymore. The soil of that garden is not gonna have plants. You cannot plant in it anymore. And the water, it's really was deep, and they cannot really get it out again. So no well anymore, no water anymore. So this is a punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you seek this dunya and you are blind about the akhirah, Allah will punish you. And when you only take care of akhirah and you neglect your body, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be happy with that. Because you did not take this dunya as a mazharah for akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to do this balance, especially when we live in this time, too many materialistic issues out there, to make this balance in our life. إِنَّهُ سَمِعُ مُجِيبُ قُلُّهُ رِيَبَ. أستغفرك ربي لا أحصيها لنا عليك أن تكن أثنيت على نفسك. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن الصالحين. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. عباد الله اعلموا أن الله قد أمركم بأمر عظيم بدأ به نفسه وثنى به على ملائكة عرشه وثلث به على عباده الصالحين. فقال عز من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الكريم وعلى من سار بهديه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الأربعة أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي. واجعلنا اللهم في زمرتهم يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Dear brothers and sisters, finally, you were created from clay, and the spirit has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This spirit from Allah. You are from clay and you are from spirit. If you take the clay and you go back to the world, because this clay coming from the earth, the spirit, أنت مخلوق قبض من طين ونفخ من روحنا. If the clay become only for the clay, you live only for the clay, you're gonna go back to the earth. And you're gonna think about this world only. And the spirits, if you're only gonna hang up on the spirits and neglect the body, this is also not good. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you have to plant here, pray here, fast here, do the good job here in the dunya. So this balance between the clay and between the spirit of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should not be as a clay only, and we cannot be a spirit only. It's a combination. Allah created us from a body and a soul. Body and soul. To only take care of the body is wrong, and only taking care of the soul, the spirit is his own. It is why? Because Allah created us from both. He did not create us as soul only. He did not create us as a clay only. Both of them need to work together. Working together will have the right result. Not working together, then we're gonna be like the Judaism or the Christianity. Judaism who neglect Akhirah, Christianity who neglect the body. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right path. إنه سميع مجيب. اللهم برحمتك نحدث وعليك نتك لا تكلنا لأنفسنا طرفة عين وخذ بناصيتنا إلى الخير. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كل عاجله وآجله ونعوذ بك من الشر كل عاجله وآجله. اجعلنا ممن يسمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم اجعلنا الوسطية في كل شيء, ارزقنا التوازن والاعتدال في كل شيء بين الدنيا والدين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. وقوموا بالصلاه.